O-R-C-H-A-R-D-P-A-R-K, NY app Buffalo Bills coach Sean McDermott got a head start in film review during the team's plane ride home on Thursday night. His team called set extra work. The Bills suffer at their first big setback off a promising season in a 3,421 loss to the New York Jets on Thursday, with a chance to impress in a national stage and get off to their best start in 24 years. The Bills instead show that they're not ready for primetime just diet, the seesaw building process and sometimes the rest pain, and we experienced a lot of that last night and that's not fun, McDermott said. Sometimes you have to go through adversity to grow, and so that's the most important thing that we can focus in on control right now. It wasn't necessarily shocking that the Bills lost to the Jets, who have performed better than expected this year, but it was surprising how the Bills lost with problems in just about every area. 4 days after LeSean Coy ran for 151 yards in a win over the Oakland Raiders, the running game was nowhere to be found. McCoy had 25 yards in 12 attempts for on average of 2.1 yards per carry. The offensive line also struggled in the passing game. Tyrod Taylor was under constant pressure and was active at times. He was a goodie in his own and in Buffalo's first defensive play, setting the tone from the start. Buffalo's usually stout defense had no answers for New York's rushing attack. The Jets ran for 194 yards, gashing the Bills in a variety of different ways. Matt Forte had 22 counts while averaging 5.5 yards per carry, and Bilal Powell burst for a 51-yard gain in the second half that featured 3 missed tackles in the open field. The most surprising development was Buffalo struggles with turnovers. The Bills had 4 takeaways in the win over the Raiders and enter the game with the league's best turnover ratio at plus 14. Against the Jets, Buffalo surrendered the ball 3 times. This was somewhat uncharacteristic of all day over a 4 football team at this point in time, McDermott said. That said, we have had to make the proper adjustments from the game. The Bills called beginning summer reinforcements back before their week 10 game against the New Orleans Saints. Titan Charles Clayton and cornerback Jay Gaines hamstring or closet tore returning, McDermott said. They made a tremendous amount of progress, McDermott said. They've done some good things. I know Charles for a fact worked out last night and Farabeth heading in the right direction. Wide receiver Kelvin Benjamin could also make his Bills debut against New Orleans. The Bills acquired Benjamin from Carolina before the trade deadline in exchange for 3rd and 7th round picks. He has the ability to be an immediate upgrade at a position of need for Buffalo. Has gonna stick around this weekend. Ariandas already be 9th playbook, McDermott said. Has working hard on to wants to bear out through the weekend and get up to speed as quickly as possible. That's what we anticipate. Yes, if everything goes as planned, the Bills still find themselves in a good position at 53 halfway through the season. I would say that we certainly want some good things, McDermott said. We're still building. We're not where we need to be. We've won 5 games, which I'm proud of the fact that we've done that. We have to continue to build, continue to do things the right way. More info 32.app.org on this twitter.com in full.